Hi everyone. So in the previous video, I shared my entire journey of Cognizant virtual internship. Now in this part, I'm going to explain what happened after the internship, how the full-time onboarding works, and what you can expect in the first few months. After I completed my internship, within a month, I received an email from Cognizant mentioning my full-time joining location. Along with that, we also get something called onboarding pass, which comes around 3 days before the joining date. This onboarding pass is very important. You must take a printout and also carry your Aadhaar card when you report to the location. When you reach the location, the first question they will ask is, are you willing to convert to full-time? Make sure you say yes, otherwise you'll miss the chance of becoming a full-time employee. Also, one important thing, if anyone fails to report on the onboarding day, they lose their opportunity completely. There is no second chance. Accommodation tip, very important. Many people who travel to another state think that the same location will be their workplace for their long term, so they pay for the 1 month full rent in a hostel or PG. But that is a mistake, because after onboarding, within 1 week, Cognizant will allocate you to a project, and the project ODC may be in a different state. ODC means office location, so you might have to shift again. That's why it's better to pay only for 1 week rent at first, not the entire month. Project allocation phase. Within the first week, everyone gets tagged to a project. If the project has an ODC in the same location as your onboarding center, then you are lucky. But if the ODC is another city or state, you will have to relocate there. This fully depends on your luck. You might get the same location or you might get a different one. Understanding managers. Once you move to your ODC, you will have two types of managers. Project manager, who handles your project work, approves your timesheets, true time entries. Home manager, handles leave approvals, oversees your general status in the organization. Both are important, but in terms of daily work, the project manager is the main point of contact. Important reality, you may not get work immediately. Just because you got tagged to a project doesn't mean you will receive work right away. Honestly, this is a phase where most freshers have no work for months. If the project has a vacancy, they will take you in. If not, you have to wait. This waiting period varies a lot. Some people get work in 1, 2, 3 months, some people wait 6 months, in worst case, it may even up to 1 year. It all depends on luck and the project's requirement. But one thing is sure, for the first 1.5 years, no one will remove a fresher from the company just because they didn't get work. After 1.5 years, if someone remains unallocated, then they might ask for the person to resign. Tech stack reality. Don't assume that because you are trained in Java full stack, you'll definitely get a Java work. If the only opening in the project is support work, they may put you in there. That's why I recommend try to best to avoid support roles, because once you enter support, you might get stuck for years. Always tell your managers clearly, I'm trained in Java, I want developer related work. They will try to help if there are openings. But again, it's all about luck. Getting into actual project work. Once your project finally has a requirement, the project manager or a team lead will take a small interview, usually around 1 to 2 hours, depends on the role. If they're satisfied, they'll convert you into billable, and that's when your real project work begins. This is actual moment when your career starts inside Cognizant. So yeah, this is a complete post-internship to full-time journey, from getting the joining location, reporting with the onboarding pass, accommodation tips, project allocation, managers, waiting period, and finally getting into billable work. This is a complete reality of how things work after the internship.